The Labor Department says at least 167,000 workers would be affected by the two-week enhanced community quarantine in Metro Manila. These consist of about 40,000 employees who risk being laid off and another 127,000 who could see a further reduction in their pay. That's not even counting displaced workers from other parts of the country that have also reverted into a hard lockdown amid a surge in COVID-19 cases. DOLE has been providing temporary jobs and other forms of assistance since the pandemic began. But can the agency sustain these given its limited budget? Joining us on the show for more on this is Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III. The Labor Department estimates that there are 167,000 employees in Metro Manila that will be affected by this hard lockdown. Would you have an estimate of the other employees in other parts of the country that are also affected by an ECQ?
The estimate of LFS, including NEDA, is that this two-week ECQ will affect from 300,000 to 400,000 former workers.
In the whole Philippines, not yes, only in Metro Manila, I see. How much more emergency funds do you have for them to support them during these hard times, the ECQ?
We are estimating at least 2 billion for a cash assistance to these 300,000 to 400,000 formal workers. That's the reason why we requested for a additional budgetary allocation of 2 billion from PBM.
So what if the request for the cash assistance is not granted? I mean, what recourse do these employees have?
What will happen, April, is that we can utilize the funds that we have for our other program, amelioration program, which is actually a temporary emergency employment for informal workers. After all, these formal workers who will be displaced for 2 weeks can be categorized as displaced workers. So we can extend to them the same assistance from our two pagpans, which is the tulong panghanap buhay sa mga displaced or disadvantaged workers. This two-part program, April, is an ongoing program. Unlike the program that we extended to our former workers, which were provided for under Bayanihan 1 and Bayanihan 2. With or without COVID-19, we have a program called two-part for all informal workers who will be displaced because of COVID-19.
So that one is ongoing and there are still funds for that?
Yes, with or without this COVID-19. Any displaced workers will be provided with an emergency employment program.
Well, Senator Grace Poe mentioned that MSME should be represented in the IATF. I mean, what are their problems that you feel the IATF should be more aware of?
These micro, small, and medium enterprises are the hardest hit sector in terms of business collapse. Yung mga malalaki, yung mga large corporations, large businesses, can cushion the impact of this COVID-19, unlike our micro, small, and medium enterprises. They could hardly survive the effects of this so many very tight protocols, especially when it comes to ECQ protocol. Halos hindi na gumagalaw yung ating mga MSMEs. Kaya kailangan talaga i-address natin sila. And for that purpose, it may be a good idea na nandyan sila, represented sila sa IATF para ma-advocate nila yung kanilang pangangailangan.
The latest employment data shows that despite the crisis, a lot of jobs were actually created. I just like to know where the jobs are coming from, where the new jobs are coming from.
Well, mostly they come from the construction industry as well as manufacturing, including yung BPOs. Ito yung nagsusurvive even under this very difficult situation, nagsusurvive sila.
What if the ECQ is extended like it was in the past? How will Dole cope?
Well, we just have to prepare for whatever eventuality with whatever resources that we have. And we have to be very frank about it. We have a very limited resources in the department.
I do hope that this will be the last ECQ and that we will be able to cope already.
I thank you, April. Sana nga, totoo yung ano mo yung hope. Will be realized kasi talagang napakabigat ang epekto nitong ECQ, especially sa ating economy. Yung ating mga workers are the movers of the economy. Pag hindi nakapasok yung mga workers natin, pag ginutom yan, para mo na rin ginutom yung ating businesses. At pag nagutom ang business natin, definitely our economy will go down. Kaya dapat pag-aralan natin talaga kung paano natin sagubayin itong pandemya na ito without necessarily going or resulting into ECQ, si mga strict quarantine protocols, dahil napakabigat talaga sa epekto ng ating mga workers.
So with that, thank you very much, Secretary Bello, and thank stay you, safe.
Yeah. Thank you to April.